BRP Teresa Magbanua, since she was deployed last April, has successfully accomplished the mission. The mere fact that the Coast Guard vessel's presence there was able to prevent the Chinese government in carrying out the reclamation activities and also protected the marine environment. The Commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard, Admiral Gaban, recognized their effort by giving them award yesterday. As for the medical condition of our personnel, there were four who you have seen yesterday that has dextrose line, you know, because the three of them had dehydration. The other one was experiencing gout attack, which is presumably also related to dehydration. But as far as the Philippine Coast Guard is concerned, let me be very clear. The Philippine Coast Guard, and with regard to the statement of the National Maritime Council, the Executive Secretary, the Chairperson, E.S. Bersamin, it is important for us to highlight and emphasize that Escoda Shoal is a low tide elevation, has a distance of 72 nautical miles from Palawan, and it is within our own exclusive economic zone. We have sovereign rights over these waters. The Philippine Coast Guard, together with the Armed Forces of the Philippines, will never abandon our sovereign rights over these waters. We are still going to sustain our presence in these waters. Thank you very much.
Again, to have an organized questioning, so we'll just start from the front, going back, then one question, one follow-up, then we'll do the second round if there's questions.
Sir, Cecil Morelia of the AFP. I asked you this question yesterday. Objectively, we've lost Escoda because this occurred under similar circumstances to the what happened in Bajo de Masinloc in 2012. Can you convince me that this is not the case?
I think there are different circumstances that you have to compare Escoda Shoal with Bajo de Masinloc. You know, we have been mentioning this yesterday. Escoda Shoal has a total area of 137 square kilometers. For you to visualize how big this area is, it is a combination of cities from Manila, Caloocan, Nabotas, and Malabon. That's how big Escoda Shoal is. Now, what is the other significant difference of topography with that of Bajo de Masinloc? Bajo de Masinloc only has one single entrance, and that is the southeast entrance of the lagoon in Bajo de Masinloc. Escoda Shoal is composed of two lagoons on the west side and eastern side, and each lagoon has different areas where you can pass through. So this is entirely different, and again, as far as the Philippine Coast Guard is concerned, we have not lost anything. Escoda Shoal, no matter how many instances we intend to go there, we can be able to patrol and deploy our vessel. If the question is, what about before? We were not able to enter, we were successfully blocked by the Chinese whenever we do the resupply to Teresa Magbanua. It is precisely because they know where we are heading. They know that we are proceeding to Scott to Teresa Magbanua. That's why they can block the Coast Guard vessels. But right now, there is no reason for us to be blocked. We can go to Escoda Shoal with such total area, and it's almost impossible for the Chinese government to block our intent to patrol the entire vicinity of Escoda Shoal.
Also, sir, that there is a perception that this development will make it even more difficult for the Philippines to resupply our people at Ayungin Shoal. Can you again convince me that this is not the case?
Again, while we recognize that Escoda Shoal is very critical and strategic for us to sustain our resupply operations for BRP Sierra Madre, it is, once again, I'd like to highlight, we have not lost anything. We can still patrol and maintain our presence called the show. So there is no difficulty that you are saying, since Chinese will be there. Scott the show for the Philippine Coast Guard can deploy our vessels anytime we'd like within the vicinity of Escoda Shoal.
Sir, sa ngayon, sino po yung, or anong ship yung papalit dun sa BRP Teresa Magbanua para magbantay pa rin sa Escoda Shoal dahil nga merong pinaghihinalaang reclamation activities?
These are operational details, no? But one thing that I can report to the public is that the Philippine Coast Guard will continuously deploy our vessels in Escoda Shoal.
Sir, ngayon po, kumusta yung condition ng mga Coast Guard personnel po? Meron pa po bang, tama po ba dinala sa...
Well, ang tatlong tropa natin ay na-diagnose ng ating doktor on board, no? Kasi meron tayong medical doctor sa Teresa Magbanua na kasama dun sa mission nila. They were diagnosed of dehydration, no? They were dehydrated dahil sa kakulangan ng tubig. And of course, the nutritious food, no? Gaya nga na sinabi ng commanding officer kahapon, ang kinain lang nila for almost 3 weeks ay lugaw, no? So that is one of the reasons why those three personnel experienced sudden weakness and even headaches, no? Kaya naka-dextro sila. But right now, the latest medical bulletin is nothing serious naman.
Hospital po sila, sir?
We have medical dispensary within the Coast Guard District Headquarters. And accordingly, they are attended naman ng ating mga Coast Guard doctors and nurses. At nasa ayos naman na silang kalagayan.
Sir, could you give us a sense kung ano po yung pinagdaanan ng mga Coast Guard personnel within that 5 months po para humantong po sa ganitong kondisyon na nakita natin kahapon po?
Well, kung titingnan natin ang timeline natin, no? From April, May, June, July, nakakapag-resupply naman tayo ng ating personnel. No? It was only in August where the Chinese Coast Guard started becoming more aggressive and prevented our Coast Guard vessels, particularly the 44 meters, to do the resupply for our personnel. So, ibig sabihin, starting August, eto na yung nagkaroon na sila ng problema sa supplies nila. And with regard dun sa tubig, no? Because I was asked a while ago sa mga interviews ko ngayong umaga, ang Teresa Magbanua is a modern vessel now. So supposedly, as a modern vessel, it can be able to generate fresh water using a desalinator machine. Well, that is true. BRP Teresa Magbanua has desalinator. But because of a prolonged stay and usage ng desalinator machine niya, it would require brand new filters, no? Para masabi natin yung ikinoconvert niyang salt water is potable drinking water. Dahil sa tumagal siya, hindi na siya fresh water na po-produce. Kung ang tanong mo is to at least describe, no, ng ating mga kababayang Pilipino what they went through. They went through to the point na for more than 1 month now, ang iniinom na lang nilang tubig came from the rainwater, no? At it was even mentioned by the commanding officer that they even have to, sa mga pagkakataon na walang ulan, they even have to gather water dun sa air conditioning units, no, na napuproduce. And then they're just going to boil it and that will be used for drinking and also for cooking. And again, eating lugaw for 3 weeks, obviously, is not that nutritious.
Hi sir, good morning po. Sir, siguro just to set the record straight because people are also looking at the timing of the decision to parang pabalikin yung barko doon sa Palawan, sir, no? But just days before that, naganap nga po yung Philippine-China meeting, yung bilateral meeting. So, some are finding connection between this meeting and the decision, or what prompted po itong decision ahead of na-finalize na po ba itong decision na pabalikin prior to the meeting?
Well, the decision of the Philippine Coast Guard to direct Teresa Magbanua to go back to the port is not related whatsoever to the meeting that the Department of Foreign Affairs had with the Minister of Foreign Affairs. We don't have any, guidance from the Department of Foreign Affairs for this kind of operational details. The decision of the Commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard, Admiral Ron Hilgaban, to pull out Teresa Magbanua is a decision that he made because of the welfare of the Filipino Coast Guard vessel, the seaworthiness of the vessel, and again, the most compelling factor is obviously the bad weather condition.
Sir, good morning. Sir, considering yung mga challenges na pinagdaanan ng mga troops ng BRP Teresa Magbanua, paano natin pinaghahandaan naman yung deployment ng susunod na barko na pupunta doon sa Bina Shoal, considering na possible na ganito din yung pagdaanan nila and may mga challenges silang karapin sa mga Chinese vessels po?
Alam niyo, sa totoo lang, if you're going to ask any personnel on board 9701, and even the commanding officer, you saw him very emotional and teary-eyed yesterday, it's because he felt bad na he has to go back. Ang crew ng Teresa Magbanua really has this commitment and determination to stay longer sa Escoda Shoal. So I don't think we need more pep talk to our personnel or any other Coast Guard vessel na madi-deploy dito. Any Coast Guard personnel who are assigned to any Coast Guard vessels would be very much willing to carry out this patriotic duty in maintaining our presence in Escoda Shoal.
Sir, just to follow up on that question, paano yung plano natin? Will there be changes on the strategy considering na na-experience yung problem on resupply dun sa BRP Teresa Magbanua? So what will happen dun sa susunod? Paano natin ma-ensure that they will have enough supplies for them?
Those are operational details, but one thing that I can emphasize is that we're still going to maintain our presence in Escoda Shoal. Regardless what size of vessel, regardless how many vessels, the main objective and the commitment of the Commandant, Admiral Gavan, is to make sure that at any one time, there will be a Coast Guard presence in Escoda Shoal.
So, sir, yung pong BRP Teresa Magbanua, yun na rin po ba yung ibabalik dun sa Escoda?
No, because BRP Teresa Magbanua still has to undergo repairs. And the personnel needs to undergo medical and physical evaluation as well. So there are other Coast Guard vessels that where we can direct to maintain our presence in Escoda.
Hi, sir. Jerome Morales from Reuters. Yesterday, Yusek Lopez mentioned that nagbigay na ng direktiba yung command na siguro nasa Laon na yun. Can we confirm if we already have presence right now that replaced Teresa Magbanua?
Let me clarify who mentioned this.
Isaac Lopez yesterday, nagbigay na daw ng direktiba yung ating commandment na siguro nasa Laot na yung replacement vessel. So how do we have presence at this moment?
Again, these are operational details. I won't be disclosing it to the public.
Okay. Just a follow up on that. So repair and maintenance of the Teresa Magbanua, of course, that's one of our most modern ships and it will be a welcome development if it returns in that area. So what's the timeline we are looking at?
Regarding the timeline of how long it will take for Teresa Magbanua to be repaired, that is something that we still don't know. Teresa Magbanua is still in Puerto Princesa, but it's not the final location for her to be repaired. It will move to another place, but I won't be disclosing it to undergo repair. The moment it she arrived to the repair facility, that's the only time we can have a definite answer how long it will take. It's for the repair facility to estimate whether it would go to days or even weeks.
And one last, Commodore. Does maintaining presence in Escoda Shoal mean mag-a-anchor ulit tayo or just patrolling presence that we are mentioning?
These are operational details. Whether we anchor or we loiter or we sail within Escoda Shoal, these are operational details. I cannot clearly discuss what are we intend to do. Again, our commitment is to deploy a vessel there, fly our flag there, and that's the only thing I can respond to your question.
Sir Marlene Padiernes po sa Teleradio Servicio Radio sa East 30. Sir, mula nung umalis po yung BRP Teresa Magbanua doon sa Escoda Shoal, nagkaroon po ba ng paggalaw doon sa mga Chinese vessels sa lugar. May na-monitor po ba tayo?
Well, alam nyo, no? ang mga Chinese maritime forces, kung ano man ang lakas ng alon, pangit na panahon na pinagdadaanan ng Teresa Magbanua when she was in Escoda Shoal, that doesn't make them invincible. Kung anong pinagdaanan natin, yun din ang pinagdadaanan nila. Regarding sa malalaking alon, malakas na hangin, malakas na buhos ng ulan, this is the same thing that they have experienced. What I can say is that we have monitored also that the Chinese Coast Guard vessels who were there have also significantly diminished because of the very bad sea condition in that area.
Okay, sir, nabanggit po ninyo na hindi niyo masabi sa ngayon kung ano yung timeline kung kailan ito makakapag-deploy ng or mare-repair itong BRP Teresa Magbanua, at hindi niyo rin po mabanggit sa ngayon yung operational details about doon sa deployment ng mga barko ng Pilipinas. Ito po, sir, sinasabi niyong sama ng panahon, malakas na ahampas ng alon doon sa lugar. Isasamantalahin ba natin ito, sir, yung oras, yung panahon na ito para makapaghanda ulit sa panibagong deployment po doon sa Escoda Shoal?
Well, again, I'm not saying that we haven't deployed yet. I'm not saying we are about to deploy the moment the weather permits. What I'm saying is that there are already plans in place for us to maintain our deployment in Escoda Shoal.
Thank you po.
Good morning, Commodore Tariela, sir. Gina Mapi po, nandito po www.774. Sir, yung mga supply, nagkakaroon ng problema doon sa mga barkong dinideploy ninyo. 5 buwan po yata yung Teresa Magbano doon sa Escoda Shoal. Yung po mga supply na to, hindi ba kayang dalhin ng barko sa loob? Yung supply sa 5 buwan, di ba kayang dalhin ng barko? O baka pwede nang ilagay para hindi na nagkakaproblema sa resupply mission. At saka sir, yung filter sa tubig, desalination, di ba? Di ba mahalaga yun? Hindi pa maaaring magdala ng reserba para yung mga tauhan na PCG naman ay hindi nalalagay sa alanganin yung kanilang kalusugan.
Well, regarding the filters and needed equipment for the desalinator, let me take this opportunity to thank the Embassy of Japan. They are the ones supporting us to acquire those needed filters. Secondly, ang mga filters na to ay hindi ganung kabilis ma-acquire. Hindi siya locally available na katulad sa mabibili sa Ace Hardware. Ganun siyang kahirap. No?
Yes, we know. Yes. But you are yes. the Philippine Coast Guard. It has expected of you to be a...
Yes, ma'am. I'm responding to your question now. So what I'm saying is that nobody has ever expected that we're going to have difficulty now in bringing in those supplies. And nobody also thought that the prolonged stay of BRP Teresa Magbanua would go to the point that the desalinator machine would also not be functioning well. Kaya nga sinasabi ko po, ma'am, we have already talked to the Embassy of Japan. They are now helping us to procure those additional filters. Regarding sa pagkain, these are operational details as well. Bakit kinulang, paano ang gagawin natin sa mga susunod na panahon? I cannot disclose, but these are, as you said, lessons learned for us in considering the next deployment.
Sir, nahihirapang dumaan sa tubig yung ating mga resupply mission. Di ba pwedeng gamitin ng air? Ibawa commission ng Philippine Air Force para dun sa ating mga barko? Para hindi
we did airdrop resupply last August 28.
Yes, sir.
But again, this is also subject to weather condition.
Yes. Okay, thank you.
Hi, sir. Magandang maga po. Michael Rogas po from Radyo Pilipinas, sir. Paano po natin matitiyak na yung lugar na inalisan ng Teresa Magbanua ay hindi po okupado ngayon ng mga Chinese Coast Guard?
Well, again, sir, no? Ulitin ko. Ang buong Escoda Shoal ay may total area na 137 square kilometers. Once we say the vicinity of the Escoda Shoal, that's how we can, you know, view it, no? 137 square kilometers ay kombinasyon ng cities ng Manila, Malabon, Nabotas, and Caloocan. Ganun siyang kalaki. Kung ang tanong mo, sir, is makakapag-deploy pa rin ba tayo ng barko sa laki na to? Obviously, napakalaki ng total area ng Escoda Shoal. If our intention is only to deploy a vessel within Escoda Shoal, that is something that we can carry out. It's impossible for us to think, no? Na it's impossible for the Chinese government to carry out na ang buong Escoda Shoal ay haharangan nila. Just like my response with, sir, hindi siya katulad ng Baho de Masinloc. Ang Baho de Masinloc, the entry point going to the lagoon is only on the southeastern part. The entire Escoda Shoal, there are different ways for you to enter the two lagoons from the west and east. So, there is no reason for us to go back once again in that area na sinasabi natin, doon kasi tayo nag-anchor, kaya gusto namin uling doon mag-anchor. If our intent is only to deploy a vessel to carry out monitoring the activities of the Chinese government inside Escoda Shoal, we can be able to do that.
Sir, is it safe sabihin natin hindi tayo nawala ng territory or parte ng Pilipinas sa pag-alis po ng Teresa Magbanua?
It is not just safe for us to say it, but it is wrong to say na may inabandon or iniwan or nawalan tayo ng teritoryo sa Escoda Shoal. Paulit-ulit kong sasabihin, we have not lost anything. We did not abandon anything. Escoda Shoal is still part of our exclusive economic zone. We can deploy vessels anytime we like. We can go there anytime we like. It won't be difficult for us because there are different approaches for the Coast Guard vessels to enter Escoda Shoal.
Hello.
137 square kilometers.
Sir, morning. One of the reasons why we deployed, at least sa mga narrative ng Coast Guard, was we deployed to Escoda to specifically prevent yung reclamation and occupation and presence of the Chinese Coast Guard and militias there. With the retreat, so to speak, or redeployment back to base ng of
ayaw sa'yo, Sir Chino.
With the redeployment of the BRP Teresa Magbanua, with an eye to the mission
that you will
that the Teresa Magbanua is there to safeguard and prevent the regulations, yung return niya ba, yung forced return niya, isa gifting para sa bansa.
No, it's not a defeat. As I said, related to my response a while ago, it's not also the Coast Guard abandoning our post in Escoda Shoal. We are just repositioning our own vessels. The only reason why we directed Magbanua is to address the concerns that I mentioned. But it doesn't mean that the Coast Guard vessels will no longer be deployed there. Again, these are just operational details, but you have the commitment of the Commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard. We have other Coast Guard vessels that, as we speak right now, may have been or may already been proceeding to Escoda Shoal. But again, these are operational details.
But we can guarantee na wala circulation na mangyayari dahil wala tayo.
Alam mo, Sir Chino, reclamation of the Chinese maritime fisheries took them almost 4 years. From 2013 to 2017, this is how long they reclaimed Mischief Reef, Gavin Reef, Quarteron, and other areas. No? Hindi naman siguro mare-reclaim yan kung in just a matter of hours nawala tayo. Well, Sir Chino, kaya nga sinasabi natin, no? Ang Teresa Magbanua let us not discount the fact that they were successful in their mission for 5 months. The mere fact that the Coast Guard was able to prevent the reclamation from happening from April until the last day she left there. Ibig sabihin, the Coast Guard can carry out whatever it takes for us to make sure that China will not be able to occupy and even reclaim Escoda Shoal.
The situation on Escoda Shoal is getting harder. So what support can your security partners, the US and Japan, offer? What support do you need?
Well, these are questions that is better addressed to the Department of Foreign Affairs or the Department of National Defense. But let me take this opportunity to thank the Embassy of Japan again for the filters of our desalinator. We also have requested for the spare of those desalinators. As you are aware, the Coast Guard vessels that we have, the 9701 and the 44-meter vessels, are all constructed by the Japanese shipyards. So those kind of support can also be needed by the Philippine government, by the Philippine Coast Guard.
Hi, sir. Mark, the street. Hello, yan. Sir, I know operational details you can't really give, but bakit hindi tayo bago palabasin, bago tanggalin po for now yung BRP Teresa Magbanua? And hindi po ba risk yon na we left it nga to the Chinese? Hindi po ba mahihirapan tayo bumalik? I understand it's so much bigger, but they have so much more ships. And we've seen a more aggressive China these past couple of months. Wala po ba tayong concern? Baka sir, baka you can explain, ba't hindi tayo nakapagpalit?
Alam mo, Mara, meron kaming concern. Hindi kami sa wala concern. No? But again, uulit-ulit, no? The bad weather condition has compelled us to deploy, to, you know, recall our vessel in Escoda Shoal. Kung ang intention lang natin is to retrieve itong Teresa Magbanua, the question is, kung meron din ba tayong capability na maglaot from Palawan going to Escoda? Kung pangit nga ang panahon dahil nga i-recall natin. I mean, logically speaking, it's very difficult for us to explain, but that's the only way we can, you know, explain this kind of things.
One last question for me, sir. Sir, are you seeing China doing more blockades within the West Philippine Sea? And what can the Philippine Coast Guard do given that, you know, they're more superior in terms of equipment, in terms of the number of vessels they are able to deploy, not just Coast Guard, but also, you know, their maritime condition?
Well, let me first correct you. No, let us not use blockade because blockade has a different connotation. The Chinese government, the only thing that they're doing is to harass and to unlawfully carry out dangerous maneuver in the entire West Philippines. I don't think that blockade is the right terminology to describe this kind of illegal and barbaric activities of the Chinese maritime forces. This kind of actions have always been considered. We are always calibrating our approach and deployment of the vessels in the entire West Philippine Sea. And I think it's not also accurate to say that the Chinese maritime forces have been very effective in harassing our deployment in different areas of the West Philippine Sea. It is only pretty much targeted. Like, that's what they do in Bajo de Masinloc, also in Ayungin, also in Escoda. But the entire West Philippine Sea, it's a very big body of water. So I just want to make this an opportunity to explain that once you write something in talking about the West Philippine Sea, clearly define it like it's a targeted harassment. Not harassment in the entire West Philippine Sea, because it has different connotation.
Good morning.
There's information that a 44-meter ship has been deployed or will be deployed to replace
Well, una sa lahat, no? For the desalinators. Ang desalinators ay ipina-DHL na nila. Tama ba, attorney? That's how fast the Japanese, the Embassy of Japan help us for the filters. So hopefully within this week, filters will be arriving na sa kinuha pa nga nila ang address ng headquarters kasi door-to-door talaga to eh, ng DHL. No? We are expecting 4 sets of desalinators. So, dalawa para sa 9701 and dalawa para sa 9702. So, I hope I already answered your question. For the for your first question about the 44-meter vessel, of course, the 44-meter vessel, it has longer duration of patrol, somewhere between probably 7 to 10 days a week for additional 3 days. But it doesn't mean na pag dumating ulit doon, aalis na naman, we can be able to, you know, strategize like 144 and then replacement in place, another 44 meter or 97 meter for much longer, those kind of things. But again, these are operational details that I don't want to explain further, but at least for you to have an understanding that follow that we have smaller vessel and we're a bit, you know, not considerate about the number of days we can stay in Skoda.
Hi, sir. Good morning. Bea Kupin from Rappler. Sir, there have been, as mentioned earlier, inevitable comparisons to the Baho de Masinloc standoff in 2012. I understand you've already explained the difference, but I think one stark difference here is that leading up to the Magbanua's return to port, it was months, weeks of really intense harassment, brute force from Chinese maritime forces. What does the PCG and the MTF perhaps also think of these comparisons, again, to the 2012 standoff in Baho de Masinloc? And what does this say, you think, yung changes between a decade about China's actions or the shift in China's actions in the West Philippine Sea?
I think that's better addressed by the National Maritime Council. Ayoko mag... Kasi pag nagsalita ako, baka sabihin. Again, let us stop comparing Baho de Masinloc with that of Escoda Shoal. Napakalaki ng pinagkaiba niya, no? Baho de Masinloc, ulitin ko ulit, isang entry point lang. Kaya nga every time na magpapatrol yung Coast Guard, BFAR, alam niyo rin yan, you've been embedded whenever we go to Baho de Masinloc. Yung nag-iisang entry point na yon na hindi na inalisan ng Chinese Coast Guard sa loob ay nilalagyan pa nila ng harang to make sure na nobody gets inside the lagoon of Baho de Masinloc. Escoda Shoal is entirely different. Ang dami niyang pwedeng pasukan. Ang lagoon niya hindi lang din nag-iisa. Alam mo, nakapunta na rin kayo ng Sabina. Meron siyang West Lagoon, East Lagoon, at for each lagoon, there are more than 5 entry points na pwede mong pasukan. So I don't think that there is a similarity between Baho de Masinloc and Escoda Shoal. Regarding the change, I think the NMC can respond to that.
Okay, good morning, sir. I'm going to belabor you again on that part.
Na-miss ko na to si Barnaby. Ngayon lang kita uli nakita.
Talaga? Ah, okay, sige. I'll go with, sorry, but I have to belabor you again.
You always.
On that point, yes. Wouldn't it be fair to say that the Philippine Coast Guard or the Teresa Magbanua was forced to retreat or because of the strategy of the Chinese to starve the crew of the Teresa Magbanua? You know, as we all saw, the crew members came back to port dehydrated and ill. And if that is so, then they would just keep doing that. And they could also do that because you know, for us who have been to the second Thomas Shoal or Ayungi Shoal, Sabina Shoal is on the way to Ayungi Shoal. So would it also affect the resupplies to the BRP Sierra Madre?
I think forced by the Chinese to for us to go back, I don't think so. Hindi naman ako naniniwala mas malakas sila kay Lord para magpabagyo ng Palawan. Diba? Again, it's not just the supplies that compelled us to go back to the port in Puerto Princesa. It's the bad weather condition. Supposing that that it's a fair weather, it would be very easy for us, just like what Ma'am Mape said, to do airdrop or other ways, right? Because we have done it last August 28. There are other possible ways for us to sustain our stay in Escoda Shoal. But the bad weather condition is really the primary factor that made the commandant decide to bring Teresa Magbanua.
But with dozens of Chinese ships there, are they able to establish a more permanent presence than the Philippine government?
No. I would argue that permanent presence is not something that the Chinese maritime forces have already done in Escoda Shoal. As I said, when Teresa Magbanua deported Escoda Shoal, the Chinese forces are also subjected to that bad weather condition. It's not just 9701 who left Escoda Shoal. We can document that even the Chinese have also left because of that very bad weather condition.
And there's dozens of Chinese ships there. You know, you mentioned that the area is much larger than the Scarborough Shoal. So despite the presence of dozens of Chinese ships there, those dozens of Chinese ships, maritime militia, Coast Guard, Chinese Navy, they're not going to be enough, in your opinion, to block the Philippine Coast Guard from entering the shoal.
Yesterday, the only number of vessels that were there is down to 11 Chinese maritime militia. There were no Chinese Coast Guard vessels. There were no hospital ship, no PLA Navy tugboats as of yesterday.
Hi, sir. Good morning. Maricar po. Sir, clarification lang, sir. Yung recall of the Teresa Magbanua, it was a call made by Admiral Gavan. And kailan siya, sir, nag-decide to recall the ship?
Again, the very bad weather condition for so many times. No? Ang pangit na panahon ang talagang nag-compel kay Commandant to recall Teresa Magbanua. And of course, the dwindling supplies and those personnel who needs medical care.
But sir, wala sa plano, supposedly, dapat mag-extend pa sana si Magbanua, sir?
Yes. As I said, even the commanding officer, no, has to apologize when he reported for his mission accomplishment in Puerto Princesa. He was teary-eyed and then he said, I'm sorry, sir, I have to bring back the vessel. It's because it was never really our plan during that time for Teresa Magbanua to go back to the port.
Thank you, sir. Sir, last na lang. Sir, if I remember correctly, sir, during the ramming or collision ng Teresa Magbanua, there was mentioned na parang you are or the NDF is considering na i-extend yung provisional agreement from, currently Ayungin to cover Escoda. Can you tell us, may ganun ba, sir? Is there, are there talks going on about, and then where are we?
I think that kind of question is better addressed by the Department of Foreign Affairs and the National Maritime Council. Just for the record, it's not the idea of the National Task Force West Philippines. I think somebody else said it.
Sir, follow-up question. Are we not considering at this point to perhaps, one, send Philippine Navy ships as well to the shoal to, you know, augment the PCG's vessels, because we know that several vessels have been damaged rather substantially during missions to Escoda Shoal.
Bea, as a Coast Guard officer, I can only talk about the deployment of Coast Guard vessels.
moving beyond the Philippines, sir, are we not considering at this point to ask the help of our partners, our allies, in, you know, in entering Escoda again, future patrols, perhaps in the West Philippine Sea? Is that not yet a consideration at this point?
The response to that question is beyond my pay grade. It's for the DFA and the DND to discuss.
Sir, just to follow up on what you said, that it wasn't the WPSTF who's that proposed to for the extension of the provisional agreement in Ayungin. Why do you not think that it was wise for the to extend the provisional agreement to cover Escoda? What was the the argument against it? Why isn't it beneficial to the Philippines?
I have my personal response to that question, but again,
personal response as well.
I won't comment on that. And again, for the record, it's not the National Task Force who said that. It's somebody else.
Yes, but what does the what does the task force feel that would be the better course if it's not to extend the provisional agreement? What else can we do to to make it easier for our forces to resupply whichever ship is already deployed?
I'm only authorized to discuss operational details as to that kind of diplomatic and policy issues. It's for the DFA and the National Maritime Council to respond.
Sir, very quick follow-up lang. Sir, magpapadala pa rin tayo ng ship, di ba sir, sa Escoda Shoal, pero hindi pa natin madidisclose. But sabi po, mission accomplished na si BRP Teresa Magbanua. And kung magpapadala pa po tayo doon, does it mean na mayroon pa siyang kailangang bantayan doon sa Escoda Shoal? And gano'n pa po katagal do you think itong mission na to would entail?
Well, the deployment of Coast Guard vessels is not just purely focused in Escoda Shoal. Of course, as you are aware, we pass through different maritime features that we occupy. But it doesn't mean that we're just going to purely concentrate in Escoda Shoal.
We will entertain last question.
Hi, Sir Mads from Net25. Sir, yung decision ba to recall Magbanua is sole decision of Admiral Gavan? Hindi niya ba kinonsulto sa Malacanang or someone higher than him?
Well, of course, it was consulted. Those people who have who needs to give the green light for Admiral Gavan, they were consulted. As to the specific people, I don't want to disclose. Tapos si Barnaby.
Sir, parang ang malinaw lang din.
Could you also say this? Parang, we did that.
Parang ito yung message ngayon ng press ko na to, sir. We did not surrender. The Philippines did not surrender po.
Yes, we did not surrender. Lagi ko kasi sinasabi, wala naman tayong isinurrender. Wala tayong isinuko. The mere fact na pinull out lang natin ang Teresa Magbanua, it is wrong to say na isinuko na natin. And it's also wrong to say na kapag nawala tayo doon, magre-reclaim. Again, the reclamation would take 4 years. Kung mawala ba tayo ng isang araw, dalawang araw, tatlong araw, isang linggo, makagawa na sila ng runway, right? It doesn't go that way. Second, pag sinabi ba natin, nag-pull out tayo, hindi na tayo makakabalik. Paulit-ulit ko ang sinasabi, napakalaki ng Escoda Shoal. Hindi siya katulad ng Bajo de Masinloc na isa lang ang papasukan. Marami siyang papasukan. So, it's a misconception na sinuko natin, hindi na tayo makakabalik. Definitely, wala tayong isinuko, wala tayong inalisan, dahil pwede natin itong balikan in different ways. Second, again, the commandant of the Philippine Coast Guard, sinabi niya na rin to, and even the NMC spokesperson has already disclosed na meron tayong deployment ng Coast Guard vessels. It doesn't end na sinabing ang Teresa Magbanua, binunot na, ibig sabihin isinuko na. Kasi paulit-ulit namin sasabihin, ang Escoda Shoal ay patuloy nating titindigan, patuloy nating pagpapatulyahan, and our deployment in Escoda Shoal doesn't end dahil pinaalis natin si Teresa Magbanua.
series of clashes in August and with the back to port, would you now conclude that the hotline that was established between the foreign ministries of China and the Philippines isn't working?
Well, I'm not sure about the hotline of the Department of Foreign Affairs and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, whether it's working or whether they're using it. I think that question is better addressed to the Department of Foreign Affairs. Thank you very much.
Thank you.